Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I'm Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand carrier sense multiple axis collision avoidance. The concept of carrier sense multiple axis with collision detection has already been discussed in our previous video. If you haven't watched those videos, please watch those videos and come back here. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concepts. In this class, so this is carrier sense multiple axis and it is used for collision avoidance. So with collision avoidance it is provided and it is used in the wireless networks, whereas collision detection is used in the wired networks. And the collision detection cannot be used with the wireless networks. Why it cannot be used with the wireless network is it is due to the attenuation in the signal. Attenuation means it is the reduction of the strength of the signal in the transmission is what we call it as attenuation. So as and when the signal is getting transmitted, as it goes the as it transmits through a distance, so the signal strength will get reduced. In the collision detection, after the collision, after occurring the collision, it has to come back with a solid strength, with more strength, so that it can be received at the so that this signal, this distorted signal, has to be received at the source. But as the attenuation, as the signal strength is getting reduced in the wireless networks, which does not happen in the wired network, the signal strength is comparatively stronger when compared with wireless networks. So this distorted signal may not reach the source and the collision cannot be detected. In order to for the wireless networks to avoid collision, so in the wireless networks we can avoid collision. How that collision can be avoided is it is based upon the concept called distributed coordination function, DCF. It is based upon a concept called distributed coordination function. So what this is, so it is a wait period of time. So how this functions, how this collision avoidance will work, that we will try to understand with this diagram. So what happens is whenever a station wants to transmit the data, it will continuously sense. Whenever it identifies that the medium is idle, what it will do is it will wait for IFS time. IFS means it is inter frame space. So what that IFS means is it is inter frame space. What is that amount of time is? It is the amount of time taken by that particular station. It is the amount of time taken by the data that is transmitted by that particular station to receive the to get transmitted to the receiver. So that is what we call it as IFS time. So within that IFS time, which means that, so it whenever it finds that the signal is medium is idle, it will wait for IFS time. So within that time, so why it is going to wait for IFS time is at the start of that, whenever it senses the medium as idle, there is a possibility for the same for the receiver to transmit the data at that same time. So for that not to happen, what the system will do is, what our station will do is, it will wait for IFS amount of time. So this is the inter frame space. This is inter frame space means the amount of time that it will take for the data frame to transmit from sender to receiver. So to that particular period of time it is going to wait, and after that IFS time, if again the system senses the medium as idle, it is going to wait for contention window. So it is going to wait for this amount of time. So this is what we call it as contention window. So what is this contention window is? It is the time period which is divided into slots. So it is going to choose a certain number of slots will be chosen, and to those number of slots, this entire time period is going to be divided into slots, and these number of slots this system is going to wait for. So this is what we call it as a contention window. After IFS time, if the channel is still idle, it is going to wait for this contention window, this amount of time. Contention window means this is the amount of time which is divided into slots. What happens in this contention window is, after every slot the station is going to sense the channel. If the channel is idle, it will go for the next slot. If the channel is busy, what it is going to do is, it is going to restart the time where it has sensed that the channel is idle. So it is going to come back. So for example, if all these videos are slots are idle, and if it identifies that after this slot the channel is busy, so what it will do is, it will go back, it will restart back from this time. For example, if it has taken 10 microseconds for this amount of time, again it will go back and it will start again from here. So this is what happens in this contention window. So if all these time slots are identified to be idle, so this entire process is what we call it as distributed coordination function. So this is the entire time until which, so this is what we call it as the amount of time that it is going to wait is DIFS, distributed coordination function. D stands for distributed coordination function inter-frame space. So this is the amount of time until which the sender is going to wait for, and after that, if it senses that the channel is idle, it will send frame, and after that the timeout will receive. So what happens after that, that we will try to understand from this diagram. So that part of time is what we call it as distributed coordination function. So this is the diagram. So what happens if A and B wants to communicate, source and destination? So if A and B wants to communicate, it will wait for DIFS time. So that is the period that we have seen, which includes IFS time, inter-frame space, after that contention window, after that. So combining those two is what we call it as DIFS time. After that, it is going to send. It is going to send RTS. So this entire process. So this entire process is broadly divided into three strategies. First strategy is IFS time. And next strategy is contention window. So as we have seen in the above diagram, window. And the third strategy, so this is what we call it as acknowledgement. So what these acknowledgements, that we will try to understand. We have seen IFS, next contention window, next is acknowledgement. So after DIFS amount of time, this is the sender, it is going to transmit an acknowledgement. So this is a very short control message. What it consists of is, so this RTS, request to send. So the sender is going to send a request that I want to send. So this RTS packet, this is a very small control frame. So it will get transmitted to the destination. After receiving, what it consists of, what this RTS consists of, it consists of source address and receiver address, and apart from that, it consists of the amount of time it want to occupy. So the time it want to occupy, it want to send the data. So the amount of time it want to send the data between the source and receiver. So this is what this small control frame consists of. After receiving at that, it is going to wait for SIFS time. So usually this DIFS time will be 50 microseconds, and this SIFS time means it is a short interframe space. Usually it is going to be 10 microseconds. After that, what happens is, after this 10 microseconds, if it finds that the channel is idle, so the receiver is going to send CTS. CTS means clear to send, request to send, and next is clear, clear to send. So it is sending a signal that now I am ready to accept your packet. So after receiving this, so in the process of sending the CTS, what the receive destination will do is, it will transmit that packet throughout the network. So as and when a CTS packet is sensed by the stations in the network, the remaining stations in the network, they are going to wait. They are going to wait for they are going to wait for that particular period of time. So what is the time that is mentioned? The time that is mentioned. So for example, if it wants to occupy the channel for 100 microseconds, let's assume that 100 microseconds is the amount of time that this sender is going to occupy. So based upon the CTS is also again send, it will send that, so you can occupy this amount of time. This amount of time is acceptable. So the amount of time that is acceptable will be transmitted by the destination in the CTS. So that amount of time will be transferred to all the systems. All the systems are going to take that CTS and they are going to wait for this period of time. So they are not going to sense the channel. They will not sense the channel, and this NAV means it is a network allocation vector. That is the amount of time the network will be allocated to the sender. Network allocation vector means, for example, it is 100 microseconds. That 100 microseconds, none of the other systems in the network are going to sense the network. Okay, so whenever if this system, so in the process of this network allocation vector, within this 100 microseconds, if this C system wants to transmit the data, it will check for the network allocation vector. If the network allocation vector is not ticking of the time, so then it will again go through this entire process. So that is what we call it as network allocation vector, where there is no collision. So the collision is completely avoided. See here, is there any possibility for collision? No, because all these systems are not trying for the, are not going to sense the channel. If they are not going to sense for the channel, there is no possibility for collision. So the collision can be avoided. So let's try to understand. After receiving the clear to send, it is going to wait for SIFS time and the data will get transmitted. And after the completion of the data, after the completion data being completed, it is going to wait for the receiver is going to wait for SIFS time, and again the acknowledgments for the data will be transmitted by the sender to the receiver, by the receiver to the sender, and the same acknowledgments are transmitted. From this they are going to understand that the transmission has been done. Now they can start their contention. They can sense the channel and they can transmit the data. If they have any data to transmit, they are going to sense the data, sense the channel, and they are going to transmit the data. So this is how the collision avoidance is done. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. And if you feel that this video is helpful to you, please give us a like symbol and please share this video with your friends so that they will also get benefited.